Donald MacLeod on the groat. Basically, as we go through the ground, the even-numbered pulses in each bar are very slightly longer than the odd-numbered pulses. When we play the double echoes on E, we shorten the last E of the movement. We make up for this by dwelling as long as possible on the first strike, as long as possible without throwing the tune out of context. In bar 3, line 3, the first note E, I play as a themal note. So line 1 might sound and do ra do and do ra dre and re o dre re o dre and do ra do and do ra dre he re o dre and do and he la dre and do la dre long and he re o and he o and similarly throughout the order. Singling of the shoal, if we observe the pauses where we see them, then it is quite straightforward. The doubling that tiny little bit quicker. Variation, which in fact is the G, D, and E movement. Ever so slightly towards the end of line 3 of the doubling. Now in the Kronlohe you may see on the E before the cadence, that is in the singling, that this E has above it a pause mark. This is all right if you want to play that. I do not pause on the last E before a cadence in any Kronlohe singling. And the doubling, of course, is perfectly straightforward. We go for rhythmic balance. Thank you. as usual, where the Crundler movement is of the Crundler Fuskelt variety, I do not play a Crundler Mach.